External infusion pumps provide medications, fluid, and nutrients to patients in healthcare facilities and in the home. They can improve patient care by delivering drugs and other substances with a high level of control, accuracy, and precision. But they've also been a source of persistent safety problems.
Over the last 5 years, FDA has received numerous reports of adverse events associated with external infusion pumps, including serious injuries and deaths. During roughly the same period of time, there were over 80 recalls because of safety issues. Problems have been reported with a variety of pumps, including large volume, syringe, and elastomeric pumps, as well as specialty infusion pumps such as enteral, insulin, and PCA pumps.
Many adverse events are attributed to use error, but some are related to problems with device design or engineering, including software defects, user interface issues, and mechanical or electrical failures. These problems can compromise patient care by leading to over- or under-infusions, mistreatments, or delayed therapy.
FDA has launched a new initiative to address these problems in a number of ways. For example, by establishing additional requirements for infusion pump manufacturers and facilitating the development of safer and more effective pumps.
In the meantime, there are steps clinicians can take to reduce pump-related risks. Here are some of the things FDA recommends. First, have a backup plan if the pump fails, including how to get a working pump and tubing quickly, and how to get a backup battery or power supply. Use instruction manuals or troubleshooting guides, as well as the pump's drug library, if applicable. And remember the five rights for medication administration: the right patient, drug, dose, route, and time. If appropriate, label infusion pump channels and tubing with the name of the medication or fluid to help avoid errors. Don't use a pump if it's broken or damaged, even if there are only small chips or cracks. And don't use a pump if an unexplained alarm occurs or if the pump doesn't function as you expect it to. Tag the pump with details about the problem and report it. And finally, be sure that the preventive maintenance recommended by the manufacturer is performed.